بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله الذي خلق الإنسان وبناه واللسان وأجراه. سبحانه من إله عظيم ورب كريم، لا يخيب من دعاه، من توكل عليه كفاه، ومن اعتصم به نجاه، ومن فوض إليه الأمر هداه. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، تقدس في أسمائه وفي علاه. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وأسوتنا عبده ورسوله ومصطفاه وحبيبه ومجتباه، صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وعلى كل من سار على دربه واستنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فيا عباد الله، we praise Allah سبحانه وتعالى for giving us the opportunity always to recall for the good deeds and to come together and to mention Allah's name and to remember Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts Surah Al-Baqarah بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم saying بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألف لام ميم ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين الذين يؤمنون بالغيب ويقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون. ألف لام ميم. It is the book. This is the book. No doubt in it. And it is Huda, guidance for those who are pious. للمتقين. For those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For those who come together to mention Allah's name. For those who come to seek Allah's mercy and refuge. الذين يؤمنون بالغيب. Those who believe in the unseen. ويقيمون الصلاة. And they establish the prayer. وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ And they spend from their wealth for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَارْكَعُوا مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ Surah Al-Baqarah as well. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, establish the prayer. Pay your zakat. وَارْكَعُوا مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ Accomplish the prayer through ruku' and sujood. And this is a symbol of the salah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says, وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ وَإِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرًا And withhold the salah. Stay patient with salah. وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ With patience, you fulfill the salah. And with salah, you fulfill the patience. وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ وَإِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرًا It is indeed something big, something that has struggle. It's not an easy thing to accomplish. Salah and sabr. Those are two things that come together. وَإِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرَةٌ إِلَّا عَلَى الْخَاشِعِينَ Except those who are pious people and have the closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have the tranquility, خاشعين, from خشوع, from tranquility. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning this to us. وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ In different ayat in the Quran. To establish the prayer. And it's a command. It is a command. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ In Surah Al-Baqarah as well again. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا You who believe. إِسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ Help yourself with sabr and salah. وَإِنَّهَا إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ In this ayah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ Allah indeed is with those who have patience. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ This is in Surah Al-Anfal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ Indeed, the believers are, the mu'minun, the true believers are, الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ Those special people, believers, if Allah's name is mentioned in front of them, وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ Their hearts will feel emotional towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they will feel Allah's presence in their life. وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا And if the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are being recited towards them and in front of them, before them, زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا Their iman will increase. They feel the increase of the iman. They feel the barakah of the Qur'an. They feel the barakah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon them. They feel the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty. وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ And again, this is a description for those believers. They have tawakkul on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They do nothing in life except with the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they feel it, they believe in it. And then the ayah continues, الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ. Those who establish the prayer. وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ again. They establish a prayer. So one of the attributes of those believers, true believers, mu'minun, those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that they establish a prayer. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says, وَهُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ. And those believers, in different surah, وَهُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ, they take care of their prayer. When there is prayer, they establish the prayer. They don't miss it. وَهُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ. Something that is so close and near, and they love to take care of, which is salah. And the description of the ayat ends with, وَهُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْوَارِثُونَ الَّذِينَ يَرِثُونَ الْفِرْدَوْسَ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst those. Those are the believers. They will have in return Firdaus, the Firdaus, the greatest place in Jannah, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describes it for us. And this is not a joke, this is not a story to tell before going to sleep. It's a truth, true thing that we believe in. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us so, we believe in it. And this is what drives us, this is the motto for us in life. That we struggle and we pray and we have the patience because we need to accomplish what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered us to do and commanded us to do. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent His prophets, peace be upon them all, with the books and with revelations to remind people about what they should do and what they should not do. Why is that? In order to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the right way. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. For worshipping. And this worship is derived, actually, is sected into different categories. بِنَاءُ الْأَرْضُ الْإِعْمَارِ, which is, you know, establishing the earth and applying the goodness in it for everyone. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says in Surah Al-Mu'minun, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. The Mu'minun has succeeded. The Mu'minun succeeded, indeed succeeded. الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. Right away, they have the tranquility in their salah. It's not only a salah, they have the tranquility in salah. How to accomplish tranquility in salah? Inshallah, we'll cover this with Allah Azza wa Jalla. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ طَرَفَيِ النَّهَارِ وَزُلَفًا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ ذَلِكَ ذِكْرَى لِلذَّاكِرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, establish the prayer, وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ طَرَفَيِ النَّهَارِ, in all times during the day. وَزُلَفًا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ, and even parts of night. In al-hasanat, because what? Why do we do this all? Why do we have to pray to you all? In al-hasanati yudhibna as-sayyi'at. Indeed, the hasanat, the good deeds, omit and clear out the bad deeds. And we'll come to this revelation, inshallah, with the continuation of the khutbah. As-salah, the prayer has a very great and honorary place throughout the recommendations and throughout the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The salah is the only obligatory thing and sha'ira that we do in dunya that was prescribed for us in the heavens, not on earth. Everything was revealed to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Zakah, Sawm, Ramadan, Hajj, everything was revealed to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to earth. Jibreel alayhi salam came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and gave him the message. Except salah. Salah was given to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and prescribed to him and to his ummah in the skies, in the seventh heaven. This is the greatness of salah. This is how we should look at salah. Why do we have to pray? And in the hadith, Abu Hurayra radiallahu anhu, he narrates and says that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إن أول ما يحاسب عليه العبد يوم القيامة من عمله الصلاة or صلاة. Abu Hurairah رضي الله عنه says that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is telling us that indeed the first thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask you and hold you accountable for is صلاة. continuation of the hadith is, if the salah is good and he passed the salah, everything after that will be fine and easy. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it easy for the hisab. And if the salah is not correct, he did not pray on time, he did not do his salah right, that's where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala neglects anything after that. Salah is the key thing. And sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-ahdu alladhi baynana wa baynahu salah. فَمَنْ تَرَكَهَا فَقَدْ كَفَرَ. This is a strong hadith that the Prophet ﷺ reminds us that the difference between us as believers and the non-believers is this salah, is establishing the salah. You are praying, the non-believer does not pray. He does not even recognize Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ayatullah. So this is the hadith that mentions the difference between us and the non-believers. Whether they have received the message and then they went astray, or they are not even believing in the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-ahdi alladhi baynana wa baynahum as-salah. This is the difference between them and us. As-salah, the prayer. فَمَنْ تَرَكَهَا فَقَدْ كَفَرَ. Anyone leaves it, leaves salah, فَقَدْ كَفَرَ. Then he disobeyed and disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. It's really serious. As-salah, as-salah. And we remind ourselves with the Sahabi who came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he begged him, "Oh Rasulullah, I committed a mistake, a great mistake. Please do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded you to do for this mistake, al-had." So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was angry, and he looked angry because of his action, but he did not respond back. He continued, and the Sahabi begged him, "Oh Rasulullah, I need you to do so and so." And the Sahabi is feeling sorry and he wants to repent. After Salah, they prayed together. They prayed in congregation in Jama'ah. And after that, he asked for that Sahabi to come to him. And he said, "Did you pray with us?" The Sahabi goes, "Yes, Ya Rasulullah." And he said, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, "Your sin has been forgiven for your Salah." And he recited sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "Inna al-hasanati yudhibna al-sayyi'at." Indeed, the hasanat remove the sayyi'at, the sins. This is salah. And the gate of tawbah, of repentance, is salah. The gate of repentance is salah. Salah, as one of the shuyukh mentioned here on this member, he said that the salah is the dimensional way for you in this life, where you walk with this horizontal arrow, and then the connection with you is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala vertically. That means you are always connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through your salah. Through your salah. This is what Islam is, subhanAllah. If you ask someone who prays and someone who does not, make a comparison. What do you feel when you pray? And how do you feel at the end of the day if you didn't pray? And the same thing as the same the other guy. Indeed, the salah gives you the tranquility, gives you the safeness, and gives you the feeling that you are connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wherever you say, "Ya Allah," Allah responds back. This is salah, and this is how Islam is. When we are good in our salah, everything else will be fine. If we are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray on time, we don't neglect any salah, everything will be fine. And this is a proof from the Quran. This is a proof from the Quran. And this will sound a little bit harsh and hard for our minds to imagine that will happen to us, but we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us. And this is something really serious, because the Prophet ﷺ told us in his hadith that two angels came to him and he went to the heavens with Jibreel alayhi salam. And one of the scenes that he saw, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, two angels are striking a big rock into a head of a person. And this person's head comes into two pieces after they strike the sahra, after they strike this big rock. And the big rock strives to roll down. After that, they bring the two malak, bring this rock, and again, This person has his head flying and again back to its own shape, to the original shape. And they strike it. It's very severe image and situation. So the Prophet ﷺ was frightened. What is this with Jibreel? SubhanAllah, SubhanAllah, he kept saying, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why is that Jibreel? So in the narration, Jibreel alayhi salam replies to the Prophet ﷺ and he tells him, this is the person who has slept and left the salah. He slept. How many times did we sleep and miss Salat al-Fajr? May Allah forgive us. How many times did we say, I will not pray Asr right now. I have plenty of time. Let me just finish this game. Let me just finish this work. Let me just finish this meal. How many times did we neglect the time of Salat? إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ كِتَابًا مَوْقُوتًا. Indeed, the Salat has a timely limit. There is a limit for time. There is time for Salat. Fajr prayer, Fajr means before shuruq, before the sunrise is Fajr time. This is where we pray. And we've come to the ajr and the big reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the essence of the ajr. So we feel the joy and we think about Jannah. And we will feel fine. That's fine if I didn't sleep too long. If I didn't have enough sleep, that's fine. Jannah is waiting. One of the imams was asked by his student, for imam, because he saw him, a hard-working person, a hard-working imam. He cares about the people around him. He cares about the salah. He cares about everything that brings him close to Jannah, to Allah Azza wa Jalla. He says, oh imam, when do you feel the comfortable life? When do you want to rest? He says, the first foot I put in Jannah, this is where I feel rest and I feel comfortable. This is how our thinking should be towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala obligations. I will mention this story about Umar radiallahu anhu. And we probably heard this story many times. Umar radiallahu anhu was once walking and checking on people. So he saw this foreign or ajami servant for Utbah ibn Rabi'ah radiallahu anhu, for a sahabi. So he stopped by and he says, who are you? He goes, Abu Lu'lu' al-Majus. And then Umar radiallahu anhu asked him, what do you do? What do you work? Because he saw him working. He says, I make this stationery that grinds the seeds of pumpkin. So the story goes by that this person, Abu Lu'lu' al-Majusi, he threatened Umar and he says, I will show you something that everyone will hear about. Everyone will hear about. He's not a Muslim. Abu Lu'lu' al-Majusi wasn't Muslim. So the days go by and after a month, Umar radiallahu anhu is leading the Fajr prayer. This person, Abu Lu'lu' al-Majusi, is hiding in the mihrab area where the imam prays. And it's dark. They didn't have lights. It's dark. So this person sits there and he has the khinjar. He has a special knife that has two sharp metal pieces on both sides. And he soaked this piece into poison for a month. Getting ready to kill Umar, just for the hatred of Islam, as we call it today, Islamophobia, that has different shades and different colors. Look what happened, and look how Umar radiallahu anhu responded to this, even he was dying. In the second rak'ah, this Abu Lu'lu' al-Majusi jumps to Umar radiallahu anhu, and he stabs him in his chest and in his side, and the last one was under his belly button, and then he drags his knife. Umar radiallahu anhu at this point screamed, and the masjid was corrupted with this radiallahu anhu. And after that, Abu Lu'lu' al-Majusi tried to run away. So he saw the Muslimin, they're trying to come and catch him, but he kept stabbing other Sahaba. He stabbed other Sahaba and killed seven of them. So other Sahaba closed the gate of the masjid, and then one of them threw his blanket or the garment he were wearing, and then after that, Abu Lu'lu' al-Majusi felt that there's no way to run. He killed himself. Now the point is, Umar رضي الله عنه goes back with the Sahaba after they carried him to his house. He was unconscious. They didn't know what's happening. He fainted because of the injury. Ibn Umar, Abdullah ibn Umar رضي الله عنه says that I was trying to cut the bleeding of my dad. When I put my hand in his stomach, the wind fell in because of the big injury and scar. Subhanallah. After that, Umar stays up and comes conscious. He asks, "Did you pray? Did you finish your prayer?" He didn't ask, "Who did that? What happened to me? It's painful. He didn't say that. Radiallahu anhu. Their hearts were speaking. They were saying, "Did you finish prayer?" So they said, "Yes. Yes, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, we did finish prayer." And then he asked for water to make wudu. He made wudu in his situation. And he prayed to the rak'ah. After that, he calls Abdullah, his son, radiallahu anhu. He tells him, "Who did this to me?" He said, "Abu Lu'lu al-Majusi did that." Look at the response again for Umar, radiallahu anhu. He says, "The servant of Uqbah ibn Rabi'ah," he says, "Yes, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen." Then he says, look what he said. Did he say, "Alhamdulillah," that he was non-Muslim? Or did he say, "Alhamdulillah," that he's A'jami, he's not Arabi? Did he say that this person was bad? Alhamdulillah, that was killed because of that person who is not Muslim? No. Look at the scale that he's thinking of. He said, "Alhamdulillah, alladhi ja'ala mawti على رجل لا يحاجني عند الله بسجدة سجدة." أو كما قال. He said, رضي الله عنه, "الحمد لله that this person who killed me, Allah سبحانه وتعالى made this person who killed me cannot come to, in front of Allah سبحانه وتعالى and compete with me with one سجدة." With one سجدة. Because he was a Muslim. He's thinking about prayer. He's not thinking about the ethnicity of that person. Thinking about what's the great things about what's great. Radiallahu anhu. This is one story. Inshallah, we'll continue. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروه من كل ذنب إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was coming close to his death and he felt sick and the fever took over صلى الله عليه وسلم. He had a very severe fever where he had to go and leave the masjid and sit home 4 days. After that, he asked the Sahaba about praying in the masjid. And they were waiting for him because he prayed even he was sick, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. But at one moment, he could not. So, and he, because of the fever, he used to go unconscious, faint, and come back again 3 times. He asked repeatedly on those 3 times and occasions, "Did the Muslimin pray? Did the Muslimin pray outside?" They were waiting for Isha. They were waiting for the Prophet ﷺ to come out and pray. So everyone was like, "No, Rasulullah, they're waiting for you," for the 3 times. They did not. And every time he asks for water, cold water, and he asks for it where he sits sallallahu alayhi wasallam in that container and pours water on himself so he becomes conscious and fresh because of his humma, because of his fever, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Every time he wants to get up, he faints back again. He faints back again and fell down, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And after that, he asks, after when he comes back to consciousness, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he asks again, "Did they pray? Did you guys pray?" Every time they say, "Oh, Ya Rasulullah, we're waiting for you." The third time he felt that, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he couldn't make it. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "Muru Aba Bakrin فليصلي بالناس. Ask Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه to lead the prayer. Abu Bakr الصديق رضي الله عنه leads the prayer. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in the next day he drags himself by asking Ali رضي الله عنه and Abbas to come and help him out to the masjid. So both of the Sahaba رضي الله عنهما, they were dragging the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and trying to hold him to the masjid because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم felt a little bit better صلى الله عليه وسلم. So Ali رضي الله عنه is saying, wallahi we were seeing the pathways of the feet of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, we were carrying him, meaning that his feet did not even walk because of the situation he's in صلى الله عليه وسلم. And there's different narrations where the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, so he comes to the salah, first of all, he comes to the salah, and then Abu Bakr al-Siddiq was leading the prayer, so there was a little bit of corruption of the musalleen behind Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. They were saying, subhanAllah, subhanAllah, because they felt, subhanAllah, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is back, he's going to lead us. So Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم pushes Abu Bakr al-Siddiq back again, and he completes the salah with them. And let me go to the end of the story. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was dying at that moment. You know, when there is a moment of death, you will say the best and the most important thing. He did not say, take care of my family. He did not call Aisha and he said, radiallahu anha, and he said, take care of such and such. He did not call his daughters. He did not call anyone. He only said something. Only one thing. الصلاة 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 وما ملكت أيمانكم, meaning that he recommends the people and reminds them even at the last moment of his life, remember salah, salah, do not leave salah. This is the only thing that will make you succeed in life. This is the only thing that will make you enter paradise. This is the only thing that will make you better human. الصلاة الصلاة. Think about this. وما ينطق عن الهوى صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he says something, this is a revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to all of us. And after that, are we missing the salah still? Are we delaying the salah? Are we making it to Fajr? If you don't want to go to the masjid, that's fine, it's your choice. It's your sahifa. Fill it with whatever you can. But for Fajr prayer, do not miss the big ajr of Fajr prayer. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, من صلى الفجر في جماعة أو في ذمة الله حتى يمسي. Whoever prays Fajr in jama'ah, he is in the protection of Allah. He goes in the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until he comes back to his evening, until he reaches his evening in that day. And this is Salat al-Fajr. Salat al-Fajr, وقرآن الفجر, إن قرآن الفجر كان مشهودا. The angels will be there in Salat. Imagine yourself, your ruh, your nafs, praying, and the angels are surrounding you. And the angels are delivering this message that, oh Allah, this person has left his warm bed and he came to Salah. He drove, and it was cold. And he drove and he left his warm place and goes to Salah. He went to Salah. What's this ajr? What is the ajr of Salah al-Fajr? By itself. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us a better understanding of Salah and obligatory actions that we have to do. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His mercy. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His acceptance. Allahumma inna nas'aluka min fadlik. Allahumma inna nas'aluka min fadlik. Allahumma inna nas'aluka min fadlik. Allahumma ihdina fiman hadayt. Wa'afina fiman afayt. Wa tawallana fiman tawallayt. Wa barik illahumma lana fima a'tayt. Allahumma tub alayna ya rahim. Allahumma tub alayna ya rahim. Allahumma ja'al qulubana man la bidhikrik. Allahumma ja'al qulubana man la bidhikrik. اللهم تقبلنا في عبادك الصالحين وجعلنا من عبادك الموحدين القائمين بذكرك. اللهم اجعلنا للمتقين إماما وتب علينا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم احفظ ذرياتنا بالقرآن واحفظنا بالقرآن واملأ قلوبنا قرآن يا رحمن يا منان. اللهم تب علينا واغفر لنا زلاتنا في أمورنا كلها. اللهم وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين, وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.